Hey everybody, hope that you're doing well. I am at Panera working on my sermon and wanted to do the devotion for today. We are in Acts chapter 11, and it's the story of now Peter bringing back the news about the Gentiles accepting Jesus as Lord and Savior back to the disciples in Jerusalem. And so I want to read you the first part of the passage in Acts 11, and then towards the end, verses 17 and 18. In the first four verses, Peter says this. He said, "Now the apostles and the brothers who were throughout Judea heard that the Gentiles also had received the word of God. So when Peter went up to Jerusalem, the circumcision party, thus the Jewish Christians, they criticized him, saying, 'You went to uncircumcised men and ate with them?' And then Peter began to explain to them. He explained the vision that he had and what happened. And ultimately, he comes to the end in verse 17 and 18, and he says this. He said, 'If then God gave the same gift to them as he gave to us when we believed in the Lord Jesus Christ, who was I that I could stand in God's way?' And in verse 18, when they heard these things, they fell silent. The Jewish Christians fell silent, and they glorified God, saying, 'Then to the Gentiles also God has granted repentance that leads to life.'" And what I take out of that passage is the fact that we look at God in a very certain way. We look at worship in a very certain way. We look at outreach, evangelism. We look at everything that we do in a very certain way. We do it through our eyes and our focus of what's right and what's not right. And yet, sometimes when we do it that way, we ultimately are limiting God in what God can do, because we're becoming a hindrance. Just like the Jewish Christians, the circumcised party, they were a hindrance to the gospel. They were a hindrance to others who weren't Jewish becoming Christians. And sometimes we need to get out of our comfort zone, which is not fun. It's not fun for me. I don't always like to get out of my comfort zone. I don't always like to do something different and new, or some way that, you know, I like to play disc golf, and if someone shows me a new way to play, a new way to throw that might be better for me, it's going to be very disconcerting because I've never done it that way before. And so in anything that we do in worship or in Bible reading, whatever it is, sometimes we need to be willing to shift. Sometimes we need to be willing to change. Not for ourselves, not for our sake, but for the sake of the gospel, for the sake of those who don't yet know Jesus. And that is what is so important and yet so difficult all at the same time. So I just want to encourage you, if something is ever different, don't be critical up front. Embrace it. Maybe it'll challenge you. Maybe it'll help you to grow in a way you never expected or would have thought. But maybe someone else has heard the message of Jesus in a different way that ultimately leads them to Christ. Hey, have a great day. Have a great weekend. Hope to see you on Sunday, and God bless y'all.